Hi, I'm Mary Plummer from Ripple Training, and I'm here to give you a quick look at some of my favorite new features in the latest update of Logic Pro 10. Logic Pro 10 version 10.2.1 is packed with dozens of new features, over 650 new Apple loops, and a long list of performance enhancements. Keep in mind a lot of these features are under the hood, so feel free to check out the release notes under the Help menu to see the full list. If you're new to Logic Pro, you can now launch Logic without downloading the essential content first. You can download individual files or directories as you go directly from within the library or loop browser. You can manage your sounds in the Sound Library Manager. One of the awesome improvements in the Alchemy Synth is that you can import an Apple loop as a source, and the settings will automatically configure the loop to be triggered from any key you play on a MIDI keyboard, including your on-screen keyboard. It also conforms the loop to the current project tempo. If you like creative sound design, Alchemy has 11 new spectral effects that work with the frequency spectrum, and I'll show you those more in depth in a separate video. For those of you who work a lot with drummer tracks, as you know, when you're working with a drummer track, whichever region you have selected is the one that you're going to be making modifications to in the drummer editor. It's not always the one you happen to be listening to at the time. Well, now, the drummer editor includes an auto region select button, and it looks like a playhead with a little selection around it. And what that does is that it selects the drummer region in the track as the playhead reaches it. That way you always know whichever region you're listening to is the one you're actually modifying in the editor. This next feature has to do with the arrangement markers in the global tracks. Arrangement markers, if you've worked with them, are a really handy way to organize, copy, and move parts of your song. They also work well with drummers because the drummer tracks, as you open them, will always conform to your arrangement track. The trouble you have is you're committed because once you make an arrangement marker, you've always been kind of stuck with that marker. You couldn't delete it without deleting the associated regions in the tracks. Now you can disengage the arrangement marker track, so you can edit the arrangement markers without affecting the track's area content. And whenever you're finished, you can re-engage the arrangement track. Here's a cool feature for the Drum Machine Designer, which now has an empty kit patch for building custom kits, and it supports drag and drop of multiple audio files at the same time into empty cells. So now you can populate the entire drum machine with your own sounds and then have Drummer play it virtually, or you can play it yourself on your own MIDI device. When it comes to editing audio files, Logic Pro 10's Flex tools are incredibly powerful, and up until now have only been available in the audio editor. Now, when you turn on Flex in the timeline, you can see which regions include Flex editing and modify them right in the timeline. You could zoom in to work with it up close, or you can just see them and make your modifications at any size track you'd like. Flex on, flex off in the timeline. And the last thing I'll point out is your plugins. If you look, many of your favorite plugins have been redesigned with new Retina-ready look and also interactive features and graphics. So for example, here's my Bit Crusher, as you can see looks pretty good, and I'll pull up another favorite. Let's bring up the level meter. And as you can see, I've got a nice big level meter that I can make up to 200% size, which is way bigger than the standard meter. And notice I can look at it vertically or horizontally. And I can even change where the yellow is. Right now it's at the default minus 12 decibels, but I could lower it if I was working for a feature or television, if I want to set my yellow sooner as a visual. Or I could even make it higher if I'm mastering out music or something like that. So check out your favorite plugins and see what improvements have been applied. And I hope you've enjoyed this quick tour of some of the new features. Stay tuned to this YouTube channel for some separate under 5 videos that I'll use to take you in depth to some of the new Alchemy spectral effects and building custom drum designer with an empty kit. I also have a full series of tutorials on Logic Pro that you can find at rippletraining.com. Thanks for watching.